So that brings us to our final case study, where we'll look at a testing job from about 10 years ago at a refinery. And this is still a big client of ours today. So upon initial sampling, we found that both feed streams had above threshold amounts of higher hydrocarbons, that's C2 to C6, indicating over-circulation in the amine unit, or inadequate skimming operation of the SWS. The low-quality feed streams, meaning low H2S content and high contaminants, caused low thermal conversions. And the high hydrocarbon content caused high CS2 formation, and then there was also poor hydrolysis in the first converter. So both of those things led to 1.3% combined losses in the tail gas at the final recoveries. So it's quite a bit just from CS2 and COS. And then their ADA signal was a little wonky as well. And that was because of the inaccurate tail gas analyzer readings. So they were jumping outside of the plus or minus 0.5% range quite a lot. And they're just getting under 96% recovery efficiency. So they were barely achieving their recovery license, but each stage was clearly underperforming, and we knew that they could do better. So after sampling on that first day and identifying the issues and getting the compositional analysis, the guys built a simulation model of the plant on that first night. And then they were able to provide some good guidance on the following day. So starting with increasing reaction furnace temperature by increasing co-firing, that allowed for better destruction temperature. Then we also got them to increase the converter 1 temperature to improve hydrolysis, while reducing converter 3's temperature to further promote the Claus reaction. And then finally, we lowered the final condenser temperature to 130 degrees Celsius. That's as low as they could go because of the combined condenser bed. Then the increased reaction furnace temperature lowered the ammonia and BTEX breakthrough, and it jumped the thermal conversion efficiency up to 50%. The increased converter 1 hydrolysis by nearly 10% with that temperature increase. But then with the increased co-firing rates came the elevated gas mass velocities in the condensers specifically. So that increases the risk of liquid sulfur carryover. And therefore, it was recommended that the tube sheet blanks be removed to bring the velocities back down to normal. And also, since CS2 formation was still high, we recommended that they review the circulation rates in the amine unit, as well as the skimming operation of the SWS unit. And that's to attempt to reduce the hydrocarbons and BTEX in the SRU. So when we returned for the next set of quarterly testing, we found a much more accurate tail gas analyzer. It had been calibrated. Both feed streams were more optimized with less hydrocarbons. The mass velocities dropped down into the normal range because they removed those two blanks in the condensers. This performance test, along with an incinerator optimization study, boosted the client's recovery efficiency to well above the license. It improved the upstream unit's operation, and the catalyst life was increased. This granted them huge savings in maintenance and fines, greatly reduced their greenhouse gas emissions. End up being one of many examples of why testing and optimizing an SRU is often much more beneficial than some people may think. And that brings us to the end of the webinar. So thank you guys for attending. If you like the presentation, consider looking into our on-site training, where we can send one engineer to your location and provide a wide range of courses regarding SRUs and amine sweetening units. There's just one cost per course, not per person, so they're cheap